Do you know about Spinnaker? I'm not talking about the type of sail. And no, I'm not talking about Spinnaker Towers in the UK. I'm talking about Spinnaker watch brand. Join me on this episode of Adventures with Time for a hands-on review of one of the new color models of the Spinnaker Dumas line. This is the first watch from micro brand Spinnaker that I've had in hand to review. This model, lent to my channel, is one of the four new color options of the Dumas line of divers watches. This cream color dial is called Sahara, released around August of 2021. Let's take a look at the specifications. We have a 316L stainless steel octagonal case. To be precise, it's an irregular octagon in which all sides and angles are not equal. This means we have options on how to measure the case size. Spinnaker calls it a 44mm case. That might be a measure from the left edge to where the crown guard starts. I get 43.5mm for that measurement. Measuring from 4 to 10 o'clock, I get 45.5mm, but the longest measurement is from the crown tip to the opposite side, which is 48.5mm. Case thickness is 14.8mm, lug to lug is 48mm, and the lug width is 22mm. With the bracelet size for my 7 and 7/8 inch wrist, the watch weighs in at 200 grams. That's with one link removed. The screw-down Lume logo crown is 6.8mm, giving this watch a 300-meter water resistance. A nice sapphire crystal with AR coating and powered by the Seiko NH35 movement, which I'll show you later through the display case back. Retail on this model is $400 US. However, there are discounts readily available through affiliates where I've seen it available for $300. The Dumas is one of those bulky, rugged-looking diver's watches, somewhat like the Boulder Odyssey 45 I reviewed a couple of months ago. A touch smaller and lighter, but not by much. However, I find this watch to be comfortable on my wrist. What is most notable to me about this watch is the depth of the dial. It has a clear three-dimensional look to it. There are three levels to the dial, with the base having mostly black printing, except for the automatic specification in orange. Along with the Spinnaker brand and depth rating, they've provided the 24-hour PM hours. These 24-hour labels are nice, but I can't decide if I'd like the dial even better without them. What do you think? Along the outer edge of the dial, we have this raised chapter ring with printed orange hour markers and an interspersed black minute track. The depth of the dial comes mostly from those raised hour indices outlined in black. This gives the impression that the indices are floating above the dial. The date window positioned at 3 o'clock has the same black outline. A really nice look. Now, it may be my worn-out eyes, but I find the printing of the date wheel to be a little hard to read. This is both good and bad in that it's hard to read, yet doesn't overpower the dial. Overall, I find the dial to be very readable. I would probably prefer the minute hand to be black like the other hands rather than an orange, but it's okay as is. 120-click diver's bezel is dark green and topped with some glass or acrylic. I find the bezel is very tight. I don't know if it'll loosen up with time. And I find the grip offered by the broad coin edge to be lacking. This may be due to the polished finish. I rarely use a bezel, so it's not a big issue for me. Moving to the crown, we see large crown guards and a crowned end that has similar treatment as the bezel. Though you might think the guards may interfere with the crown operation, I found it very easy to grip and manipulate the crown. I mentioned the Seiko NH35 movement. You can see that movement and the custom Spinnaker rotor through the display case back. I attribute the comfortable feel of this watch on the wrist partially to the rounded edge of the screw-down case back. While we're here at the back of the watch, note how the end links of the bracelet are wider than the 22mm lug opening. In fact, the links taper from 23.2mm down to 19.5 at the 21.5mm clasp. These links echo the hexagonal shape of the case, continuing the rugged look of this watch. These end links actually fit in under the case, which enables the bracelet to wrap around one's wrist even better, despite the totally flat case. A nice detail of this mostly brushed bracelet is the touch of polished edges between the links. This adds a bit of sparkle to the bracelet, yet reduces the potential for noticeable scratches. The usual fold-over clasp provides nice security for the bracelet, but you are limited to just 3 micro-adjustment positions, with the tightest position apparently unusable since it prevents the diver's extension from closing flat. And now a low light shot for you Lume junkies. Although the Spinnaker Dumas is yet another NH35 micro brand based diver's watch, I think that if you're looking for a solid diver's watch at a reasonable price, you should consider this one. It has very nice wrist presence with that dial design, and they offer a wide range of color options, sure to meet the liking of virtually everyone. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching, and here are a couple of other reviews of diver's watches you may enjoy.